I am Anil Kumar. Welcome to my YouTube channel and the website Global Math Institute. Here we have a very important rational function in which we'll consider horizontal asymptotes. The idea here is to inspect the equation to find horizontal asymptotes, right? The fastest way of doing it. So we have three different examples for us. You can always pause the video, answer your question, and then look into my suggestions. Now, the very first equation is y equals to x squared minus x plus 1 over 2x squared minus 1. What is the horizontal asymptote in this case? As you notice, the degree of both numerator and denominator is same, and therefore the horizontal asymptote should be what? Y equals to the ratios of leading coefficients of both numerator and denominator, and that is y equals to half, correct? Now, how do we find it? Let's also discuss the method here so that you understand how do we provide this solution in just a second, right? Okay, so we were given the equation y equals to x squared minus x plus 1. We could factor out x squared, right? So if I factor out x squared, I get 1 minus 1 over x plus 1 over x squared, correct? In the numerator, and the denominator will give us x squared when factored, 2 minus 1 over x squared. Now, when I say horizontal asymptote, it really means what happens to y when x approaches a large value, right? It could be positive or negative. Well, if x approaches a large value, then we know that 1 over x will approach 0 for sure, right? So these values will approach 0 in the particular situation. And as such, you can see that x squared will cancel away. You are left with what? You are left with y approaching a value which is the ratio of leading coefficients 1 over 2. You get the sense of it. That is how we actually do it, right? And you all are aware of that. Now the thing is, how do we figure it out so fast, right? So you understand, just compare the coefficients and write down the answer. Is that clear to you, right? So we got the first answer. Now, second one. In the second one, what do we see? We see that the degree of denominator is higher than the degree of numerator. So in this case, the horizontal asymptote should be what? Well, in this case, the horizontal asymptote is always y equals to 0. Since when x approaches infinitely large value, in that case, y will definitely approach to 0 since the degree of denominator is higher. No question about it, correct? So, you see, when the degrees are same, we're talking about the ratio of leading coefficients, but when the degree of denominator is higher, then it is y equals to 0. Always. Perfect. Makes sense. You could do the same thing there also and lead to a similar conclusion. Perfect. Now let's look into the third solution where we have y equals to absolute value of x plus 1. Now here you see the degree is same, right? If degree is same, then we do expect y equals to 1 over 2 as the horizontal asymptote. However, we have absolute value function in the numerator. Will that make a difference? This is what we need to understand. Now here we'll also learn that we could have actually two horizontal asymptotes, right? Now let's try to figure this out, right? Now we have two conditions, x approaching negative infinity and x approaching positive infinity, correct? So these are the two conditions which we will consider definitely. Absolute value of x, if you are approaching negative value, will be negative x, right? And absolute value of x, when you are approaching positive, will be positive x. Now, that makes huge difference. You get the idea. And therefore, we should consider this function as y equals to negative x plus 1 over 2x minus 1 when we are considering x approaching negative infinity. And y equals to positive value of x plus 1 over 2x minus 1 when you are considering x to approach positive value infinity. You see that. Now that tells you that we have two different solutions clearly. Here, where y equals to minus half, the ratio of leading coefficients, and in the other case, we have y is equal to half as our horizontal asymptote, right? Very clear. Ratios of leading coefficients, which is minus 1 over 2 in the first case, when we are considering x approaching minus infinity, and it is plus half when we are considering x approaching positive infinity. So, we have two horizontal asymptotes in this particular case. You get the idea. So, clearly, what we have seen here is that we have different conditions to work with. Horizontal asymptote will only be when degree of denominator, let's summarize, degree of denominator is equal or higher than the degree of numerator. Only then you have a horizontal asymptote. And we also learned that there is a possibility of having two horizontal asymptotes, since horizontal asymptote is the value of y approached when x is approaching positive infinity or negative infinity. So I hope the concept is absolutely clear. Feel free to write your comment, share your views. If you like and subscribe to my videos, so I hope the concepts are absolutely clear. Feel free to write your comments and share your views. In case you like and subscribe to my videos, that'd be great. Thanks for your time and all the best.